What's up, guys? Welcome back to the 10 or Share channel. If you see the iPhone is disabled message on your iPhone, you can unlock it using iTunes on Windows. What if you have a Mac? iTunes no longer exists on Mac since the release of macOS Catalina. Well, that's no big deal. You can still unlock it using Finder. Let's go ahead and see how it works. First, open Finder on the Mac. Then plug the phone in with an USB cord for Finder to recognize it without asking for the passcode. Let's put it into recovery mode. For iPhone 10 or later, press and quickly release the volume up and down button successively, then press and hold the side button until you see the recovery mode screen. Now here is a pop-up that suggests an update or restore. We are going with the restore. Agree to the terms and conditions. Finder will start downloading the latest iOS firmware. After that, it'll start restoring. Well done. Now it says your iPhone has been restored to factory settings, which means the passcode has been removed as well. If you're having difficulty using Finder, 4Key will make a great alternative. It offers an overall guide for all devices to enter recovery mode. You can download the firmware to any location at your choice, and then start the unlocking anytime you want. Once done, you'll see the hello screen. When setting it up, you can choose Restore from iCloud or iTunes Backup, and then get all your data back when a previous backup is available on the list. See, all our applications are getting back to the home screen. Moving on to our last part. If you use Find My, you can unlock your phone with a wireless erase on iCloud.com. All you have to do is sign in your Apple ID. Then open the Find My app. Click All Devices on the top bar. Select the phone you are going to unlock, and then go ahead and erase it. You might need to enter the Apple ID password again to confirm. Customize the settings that followed. Then the erase process will begin when the phone is connected to a network. This could be pretty fast compared to another two methods, because it doesn't involve a firmware update. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. If you think this video is helpful, don't forget to share it with your friends. See you!